with me in the studio today from the Proactive Research Unit. I'm joined by the analyst, Emma Ulker. Emma, good to see you. Good morning.
Good morning.
A reminder, Emma's full report's available by clicking on the I in the corner of your screen. We're talking MaxCyte, a trading update from them recently. Firstly, though, Emma, a reminder about the two parts of the business.
So MaxCyte is divided into two main divisions, and those comprise, firstly, it's a life sciences division, which mainly includes commercialization and licensing of its enabling technology for the cell and gene therapy field. And secondly, its therapeutic platform, which is a novel cancer therapy in the first instance, for and that is the CARMA platform. Mm.
And what can we glean from the full year trading update? It appears good revenue growth across the year.
Indeed. So yes, revenue's up ahead of consensus at 30%, on very strong gross margins of over around 90%. That's for the life sciences business in the main, and that chiefly comprises of revenues from licensing its flow electroporation technology to partners in the industry.
So five new gene editing cell therapy deals signed in the year, taking it to a total of eight commercial deals now.
Yes, so momentum is really starting to gather. Five new deals, those are the later stage deals which offer milestone payments, signed during 2019 out of a total of eight. So that sort of coincides with the explosive growth in the sector itself. Mm. And all in all, those eight deals offer milestone payments of over $650 million. So a very attractive business model. And those milestones are starting to be recognized and paid in to the revenue stream.
And have we seen some interesting data from two of these partners?
That's right. So two of MaxCyte's partnerships are starting to progress their clinical programs. And that, of course, translates into milestone payments for MaxCyte. Mm. So interesting times for the cell and gene therapy field, really starting to mature now, products entering the clinic as well as progressing through clinical studies. So offering a lot of potential for MaxCyte.
And what are the plans? What are the plans here, Emma, for the CARMA platform? Where's that heading?
So CARMA platform has already been spun out into a fully owned subsidiary. The chief aim in doing that is to clarify the value of the platform for potential investors. So clearly separating that arm of the business out so that external investors or partners can now invest into the platform. And the target is to achieve self-sufficiency in the near term for CARMA.
Mm. Well, we've seen in recent times a bit of an increase in the share price here for MaxCyte. What's your view on the current valuation?
Indeed, yes, there has been a strong run in the shares, but I think even so, looking at MaxCyte's share price or market cap at around 90 million, still compares fairly favourably if we look across to some of the valuations that peers are trading at within the sector, and that includes both enabling technology companies as well as therapeutic companies as well.
Good to get your insight, Emma. Thanks very much.
Thank you.
And Emma's full report's available by clicking on the I in the corner of your screen.